It says, let me just cut to the part that we need. Under the title, وَإِنَّ لِوَلَدَكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّا And your child has a right over you. The hadith goes. عن عبد الله بن عمر قال عبد الله بن عمر بن العاص may Allah be pleased with him and his father said قال أنكحني أبي امرأة ذات حسن رسول الله he said that my father عمر بن العاص married me to a woman that comes from a prestigious family فكان يتعاهد كنته and he used to come see and ask and see how she is doing, how his daughter-in-law doing. فيسألها عن بعلها and he used to come and ask her about her husband. فتقول نعم الرجل من رجل لم يطأ لنا فراشا and he said what a wonderful man. He is the man who did not touch us yet. ولم يفتش لنا كنفا منذ أتيناه And he did not step into our bed since he never stepped into our bed, and he did not touch me since, and I was not, and he did not expose me since he came to us. فلما طال ذلك عليه ذكر للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. When it took so long for Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As to have a relationship with his wife, his father Amr ibn al-As رضي الله عنه reported this to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألقني به. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, let me meet him. فلقيته بعد and after a while I met or after that I met رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فدخل علي فألقيت له وسادة من أدب and when he came to see me I passed to him a pillow that is made of leather حشوها ليف and the filling of it is from fiber فجلس على الأرض وسارت الوسادة بيني وبينه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم sat on the floor and the pillow was between him and me فقال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم I'm still reading from صحيح البخاري and صحيح مسلم فقال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and at that time رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said to me يا عبد الله ألم أخبر أنك تصوم النهار الدهر وتقوم الليل I have been told that, O Abdullah, I have been told that you are fasting the day endlessly forever, and the same thing you pray during the night forever. فقلت بلى يا رسول الله. Said yes, indeed, يا رسول الله. I do that. بأبي أنت وأمي. My parents are in ransom for you. قال كيف تصوم؟ The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked him, how do you fast? قال كل يوم. Said I fast every day. قال وكيف تختم؟ في كم تقرأ القرآن؟ How long does it take you to finish reading القرآن الكريم؟ قال كل ليلة. And he said every single night. And keep in mind when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said this to Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, barely a little bit over half of the Quran al-Kareem was revealed. It was not the full 140 surahs.
14,
mashallah. Still awake. Okay. And every night. He said, I read al-Quran al-Kareem, the whole Quran al-Kareem, every single night. قَالَ فَلَا تَفْعَلْ And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, do not do that. فإنك لا تستطيع ذلك because you will not be able to continue doing that. Things are going to happen. إنك إذا فعلت ذلك هجمت له العين ونفهت له النفس لا صام من صام الدهر. He said, if you do that, you are going to exhaust your eyes and you are going to exhaust your soul. Yeah? The one who fasts all time during the days has no fasting whatsoever. It's a waste of time. It's a waste of time. Why? Because this is an invention. It's not a good deed anymore. Yeah? فصم وأفطر وقم ونم. So, I want you to fast and to break fast, and I want you to pray during the night and to sleep during the night. Why, يا رسول الله؟ فإن لجسدك عليك حقا. Because your body has a right over you. وإن لعينك عليك حقا. And your eyes has a right over you. وإن لنفسك ولزوجك عليك حقا. And your person and your wife has a right over you. وإن لزورك يعني زوارك عليك حقا. And your guests have a right over you. وإن لولدك عليك حقا. And your child has a right over you. يقول الإمام النووي رحمة الله عليه قوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وإن لولدك عليك حقا. إمام النووي in his explanation of صحيح مسلم he says the saying of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم and your child has a right over you فيه أن على الأب تأديب ولده وتعليمه ما يحتاج إليه من وظائف الدين. Saying of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that your child has a right over you is a proof or an evidence or an indication that it is obligatory on the child to obligatory on the father to teach manners to discipline his child and to teach him whatever he needs to perform what the function of the deen. وهذا التعليم واجب على الأب. And this kind of teaching is obligatory on who? On the father. وسائر الأولياء and everyone guardian قبل بلوغ الصبي والصبية before the female child and before the female before the male and the female child reach the age of puberty because if you are going to wait until they reach the age of puberty when they are going to make wudu when they are going to perform the salah when it will become exhausting. That's why the general rule you teach them and train them at the age of what of 7. And you start what? Enforcing the practice at the age of what?
Nine.
Of 10. That means finished 10, started the 11th. He says, نص عليه الشافعي وأصحابه. This is the statement of Imam الشافعي and his followers. قال الشافعي وأصحابه. Also الشافعي and his students said, or his followers, وعلى الأمهات أيضا هذا التعليم. إذا لم يكن أب لأنه من باب التربية. He said, and this duty falls on the mothers if there is what? No father there. Yeah? يعني أصبح حكم الضرورة. It is now the law of necessity. There is no father. Now the mother has to carry the load. Or the extra law. Yeah? لأنه من باب التربية because this is part of what the disciplining of the children ولهن مدخل في ذلك and they have what part or they have something to do with that. Okay? Then if you bear with me I'm going to try to read to you some commentary of the ulama of tafsir. you're going to notice that they are almost identical, although the gap between them, the time gap, is huge. In regard to the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ When you have believed, protect yourselves and your families from a fire whose fuel is people and stones. قال الإمام الطبري قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ علموا بعضكم بعضا ما تقون به من تعلمونه النار. Protect yourselves, that means some of you teach the others in the things that will protect the one you teach him from the hellfire. وتدفعونها عنه and you what? You prevent them or prevent this fire from touching them. إذا عمل به من طاعة الله if they practice what they taught of the obedience of Allah. وقوله وأهليكم and protect your families too from the hellfire. يقول وعلموا أهليكم من العمل بطاعة الله ما يقون به أنفسهم من النار. And also teach your family, wife and children, the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that protect them from the hellfire. And he says, he quotes, عن مجاهد في قول الله تعالى, and this is an authentic chain of narration. عن مجاهد في قول الله تعالى, قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا, قال اتقوا الله وأوصوا أهليكم بتقوى الله. Mujahid, a tabi'i, second generation, those who learned under as-sahaba al-kiram, in regard to the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, protect yourselves and your families from the hell, he says, قَالَ اتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَأَوْصُوا أَهْلِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهُ. You yourselves have taqwa of Allah and instruct your children, your family, wife and children to fear Allah too. Start with yourself. Okay. He quotes another chain of narration about Qatada, and Qatada also second generation, great scholar. قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ Protect yourselves and your families from hellfire, which its fuel is people and hill and stones. قَالَ Listen carefully to this quote. قَالَ يَقِيهِمْ أَنْ يَأْمُرْهُمْ بِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنْ مَعْصِيَتِهِ وأن يقوم عليهم بأمر الله يأمرهم به ويساعدهم عليه وأن يقوم عليهم بأمر الله ويساعدهم إليه ويساعدهم عليه فإذا رأيت لله معصية ردعتهم عنها وزجرتهم عنها. قتادة رضي الله عنه said what? What does it mean? Protect yourselves and your families from the hellfire. He said what? The way to protect them is to command them to obey Allah and to forbid them from disobeying Allah and to keep himself observing them, always watching them, and help them to a practice and practice the obedience of Allah and to stay away from the disobedience of Allah. And if he see any disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would try them and call them away from disobeying Allah. It is the duty of the father. Allah made you a man, and this is the responsibility. Imam al-Qurtubi, who came many years after Tabari, was at the time of Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim, rahmatullah alayhi. Al-Qurtubi came years, many years, hundreds of years later. He says, وهي الأمر بوقاية الإنسان نفسه وأهله من النار. This is a command for the person to protect himself and his family from the hellfire. فعلى الرجل أن يصلح نفسه بالطاعة ويصلح أهله إصلاح الراعي للرعية. He said that means the man has to amend himself, correct himself, make himself straight, make himself righteous by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he has to what? To make sure that his family, wife and children, are righteous, are obeying Allah in the same way the governor, the head of the state, does with what? With his citizen. That is the Muslim Khalifa, Muslim ruler, Muslim governor. ففي صحيح الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم قال كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. فالإمام الذي على الناس راع وهو مسؤول عنهم، والرجل راع على أهل بيته وهو مسؤول عنهم. He said in the authentic hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? All of you are shepherds, all of you are governors, and all of you will be, all of you are responsible about your citizens. The imam, the leader, the governor, the ruler, the president, the khalifa, who is on authority over the people, is responsible for them, and he is, will be questioned about them. And the man is a shepherd over the members of his household, and he will be what? And he is responsible about them. And he says, جزاك الله خير حبيب الله كريم. وعن هذا عبر الحسن في هذه الآية بقوله يأمرهم وينهاهم. الحسن البصري explained that by his quote, he should command them to obey Allah. And he should what? Forbid them from disobeying Allah. He says, فَيُعَلِّمْهُ الْحَلَالَ وَالْحَرَامَ وَيُجَنِّبْهُ الْمَعَاصِي وَالْآثَامَ إِلَى غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْأَحْكَامِ. That means, he has to teach his child what is halal, what is haram, and he makes sure that he make him avoid the disobedience of Allah and the sins, and this applies to the rest of the rules or the rulings of the Sharia. And he says, وعن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال مروا أبناءكم بالصلاة لسبع وضربوهم عليها لعشر وفرقوا بينهم في المضاجع. Said because رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم said what? Command your children to observe the salah when they reach the age of seven. That means they finish seven, they are on the eight. And discipline them, hit them, do not beat them to death. When they reach the age of 10, that means if they miss it, and is what? Separate between them in what? In bed. We told you this is boys and boys, girls and girls, girls and boys, boys and girls. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is talking to the what? To the father. And we told you the statement of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that separation in the bed, clear cut from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, starts at the age of seven, not at the age of 10. And he continues to say many, many other things. Then he quotes Al-Kayya Al-Harasi, one of the scholars of tafsir. فَعَلَيْنَا تَعْلِيمُ أَوْلَادِنَا وَأَهْلِينَ الدِّينَ وَالْخَيْرِ وَمَا لَا يُسْتَغْنَى عَنْهُ مِنَ الْأَدَبِ. Then he quotes what? Al-Kayya Al-Harasi. He said, therefore it is obligatory on us to teach our children and our wives the religion and the good things and whatever necessary of manners. It is a very continuous, very continuous process. You want your child to be a Muslim. You want you and your child and your family to go to Al-Jannah. You do not rest until you go to where? To Al-Jannah, inshallah. And he says, and this is in agreement with the saying of Allah, وَهُوَ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. And command your family to observe the salah and you yourself of Muhammad be patient or endure offering the salah patiently. And then he quotes the hadith مروهم بالصلاة وهم أبناء سعد. Imam Ibn Kathir says قال الضحاك ومقاتل حق على المسلم أن يعلم أهله من قرابته ما فرض الله عليهم وما نهاهم الله عنه. He quotes الضحاك and مقاتل some علماء of تفسير. He said it is obligatory on the Muslim to teach the members of his family what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory on them and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade them from doing. Then again, Imam Ibn Kathir quotes the hadith مروا الصبي بالصلاة إذا بلغ سبع سنين to the rest of the hadith. Command the child to offer the salah or to observe salah when they reach the age of seven to the end of the hadith. Imam al-Jassas al-Hanafi says basically the same thing over and over, and the same thing with Imam Ibn al-Arabi, and basically they repeat the same exact thing as if they are what? Copying one another. Now, a verse from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen carefully, ya akhu. Allah says in Surah Maryam, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَاعِيلِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ وَكَانَ رَسُولَ النَّبِيَّ. الله أكبر. وكان يأمر أهله بالصلاة والزكاة وكان عند ربه مرضيا. And mention in the book Ismail, indeed he was a true to his promise. صادق الوعد. Amazing. Is there a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who was not true to his promise? Of course not. He will not be a prophet. These are what main characteristic, that means it is very clear in his character that he was what true to his promise, and he was a messenger and a prophet, and he used to enjoy on his family what used to enjoy on his family as-salah and az-zakah. You do not leave it to the chance. You do not leave it to the chance. Before you ask if your child has warm clothing or they had the breakfast or this and that, first thing, if they are up and up with their what? With their duties to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. With their manners. With their obedience to their mama, to their baba, and so on and so forth. Allah says about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the grandson of Sayyidina Ismail. فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا وَمِنْ آنَاءِ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْ وَأَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ لَعَلَّكَ تَرْضَى وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِنْهُمْ زَهَرَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا لِنَفْتِنَهُمْ فِيهِ وَرِزْقُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك والعاقبة للتقوى. Look at the context of the verses. Look. This applies for all Muslims for all times, but especially designed for us, the people who live here in America. The Muslims who live here in America. Allah says, so be patient over what they say and exalt Allah with the praise of your Lord before the rising of the sun and before its setting. And during periods of the night, exalt Him, and at the ends of the day, that you may be satisfied. That means Allah will satisfy you. And do not extend. Do not extend. That's the problem now. Do not extend. Do not extend your eyes toward that by which we have given enjoyment two categories of them. That's our problem. I want what they have, or I want to be like them. At what expense?
Non-believers.
I do not know. Different person, different expense. Do not extend your arms toward that by which we have given enjoyment to some categories of them. It is being but the splendor of worldly life by which we test them. And the risk, the provision of your Lord is better and more lasting. Yeah? Then come what? Yeah? And enjoin prayer upon your family. Shift the focus from extra worldly gains. The keyword is extra. Focus on that. Shift it to what? To maintaining your family, maintaining the religious composition of your family. Yeah? And enjoin prayer upon your family. And be steadfast therein. Steadfast therein. You yourself command them, be patient, and you patiently observe the salah too. We ask you not provision, we provide for you, and the best outcome is for those righteousness. Why Allah is saying that? One of the reasons, some people say, I'm going to work 24 hours so I can give to the charity. So what about your children? They are not the charity? It's not the charity? Does it make sense? 12, 14 hours outside the home. And the children basically, they do not see you except on what? Quality time. Spend the quality time with your children. Over there is you heard something. Nothing frustrates me more than this coin. Coin the phrase quality time. What's the quality time? Let the whole family sit and eat dinner together. How did you do in school? Good. That's the whole conversation. Yeah? Amazing, huh? In Sahih Muslim, we read about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And Aisha رضي الله عنها قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يصلي من الليل فإذا أوتر قال قومي فأوتري يا عائشة. عائشة رضي الله عنها used to say that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to pray during the night, and when it is time for him to offer the witr prayer, he would say, عائشة, get up and pray your witr. The علماء, they mentioned this hadith in relationship with the previous verse that we quoted. Look at this hadith and I'll conclude with this. Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه was not the child of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم as his son. Yes, he was his cousin. And yes, Maymuna was the wife of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the aunt of Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه. And Abdullah ibn Abbas يعني, is the cousin of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And also his aunt is what? The wife of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, who used to sleep over many, many times. And this sleep over with no reservation whatsoever, what made Ibn Abbas sleep over in the house of his aunt Maymuna. This is what made Abdullah ibn Abbas into Abdullah ibn Abbas. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us life, we'll inshallah explore that. Look at this hadith. In Sunan Abi Dawood and the chain of narration meeting the conditions of Imam Muslim. And Ibn Abbas قال بِتُّ عِنْدَ خَالَتِي مَيْمُونَ. Abdullah ibn Abbas said what? I spent the night in the house of my aunt Maymuna. فجاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بعدما أمسى. عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم came back to the house in the evening. فقال أصلى الغلام. First thing. Has the boy offered his salah. What was the age of Ibn Abbas at that time? If it was at the last day of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was 10. But I am very sure that Ibn Abbas was either 7 or 8 years at that time when this happened. First thing he said, has the child offered has the child offered his salah? قالوا نعم. And they said, yes. He said, yes. He is not his child, but he is in his what? Care. And if he is in your care, even if it's for a night or two, now you have to what? Take good care of his religious duties. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and bless our families and bless our children and help us to be the best Muslims that we can be. And last but not least, ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. Our Lord grant us from among our wives and children comfort to our eyes and make us an example for the righteous. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. The class is over. If you have any questions, corrections or other concerns, we'll entertain them in the remaining time. You are free to do as you wish. And جزاكم الله خيرا for coming and جزاكم الله خيرا for listening. Done?
Can I ask one?
Yes, sir.
Sheikh, this some of the ayah you just recited, it looks like just like فَاسْتَعْقِ مَا تُوْمَرْ وَعَارِجْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. It looks like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to emphasize on his people. We see when we become Muslim and we see our different jama'at, when they do their tablighi things, they emphasize on kufar more than, it looks like, I don't know, it looks like just like the opposite of...
the verse has nothing to do with that. It says, فَصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَأَعْرَضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. فَصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ, that means you have to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded to you, and do not pay attention to the mushrikun, do not get in debate with them, do not get in argument with them, who cares what they say, who cares what they do, who cares what that means. You do what Allah told you, and never ever pay attention to what they think of you or do not think of you, i.e. do not entertain the idea of pleasing them in any way, shape or form. Okay, anything else? Done? طيب, جزاكم الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت.